Welcome back. The markets are in the greens at this point of time, and let's take up some email queries now. We have another email coming from Nikhil Rastogi in Annanagar. He says he's bought NHPC shares at 28 rupees. What are the prospects of this shares?
See, NHPC is one stock which is a very slow mover, for the simple reason that NHPC, it's obviously hydropower, and the efficiency levels of hydropower plants are really low in India, because we don't have a continuous supply of flowing water. So NHPC per se is not a real great investment bet. If you're really looking at a high beta play in the power sector, Adani seems to be a real good bet, and I would advise him to actually shift his investments from NHPC to perhaps Adani Power. That'll be the best thing to do.
Well, so there, Mr. Nikhil Rastogi, the expert, telling you it's better to switch your shares in the power sector from NHPC to Adani. We also have another query coming in and another email. It's from Mr. Krishnaswamy in Nanganallur. He's written that he's bought Maruti shares at 1,410. How deeply will the ongoing strike affect the share prices? Does he hold on, and what are the prospects?
See, the ongoing strike is not a real big issue as far as Maruti is concerned. The thing that would actually affect Maruti more is the interest rates. Yeah. Because close to 60% of cars that are purchased in India are financed through debt. So any hike in interest rates will have an impact on the car demand. And the other thing is that the petrol prices are increasing, and so that is another factor which will have an impact. And then the other one is the government spending hasn't picked up, and the spending on roads has been really bad. So that is another factor which will have an impact on car demand. So going forward, these are the three factors that you will have to watch out for as far as Maruti is concerned. So I would say Maruti is a real good bet, because it's got a real good dealer base and a very good well-managed supply chain network. So Maruti per se is a real good investment bet, and it can give you a 20% kind of returns in the next 12 to 15 months time frame.
So, okay. Yeah. What about the automotive industry on the whole? It's in a marginal decline for
Absolutely.
A period of time. So what is the picture for that?
The reason for the decline is because the ones that I stated right now. First one is the interest rate hikes. If you take a look at motorcycles, close to 70% of the motorcycles that are bought in India are financed through debt. So if you take a look at the sector as a whole, close to 70% of the vehicles that are purchased are financed through debt. And the NBFCs, because of the rate hikes, the NBFCs have started hiking their interest rates, and the borrowing is actually coming down. And not many people actually do cash-based buying in cars and motorcycles and things like that. So I would say that the hike in interest rates would definitely have an impact, and that is what is reflecting in the numbers. If you take a look at it, the sales figures have actually started tapering down to single-digit growth. You would see that becoming flat, because the growth has to happen on a higher base as well. So these are the factors, and the other one is the petrol rate hike and diesel prices being decontrolled, which is absolutely inevitable, which will happen. So all these factors are the things that are actually weighing on the auto sector, and you will see auto sector underperforming for the next couple of quarters at least.
Okay, we have another caller at this point of time. It's Shweta from Gil Park. Good afternoon, Shweta, tell us, what's your query?
Hi, good afternoon. I bought these Reliance Communication shares at rupees 175, and I just wanted to know that are the prices likely to recover?
I wouldn't see the Reliance Arcom shares actually recovering in the near term.
Okay.
For the simple reason that there are a lot of controversies and things that shroud the telecom space, and which has directly hit Arcom as well. So the only telecom bet that you can look at is Bharti. So I would advise you to perhaps shift your investment to, if you're really particular about telecom, then you can look at shifting your investment to Bharti, where you can make some real good, some decent money. Or you can perhaps look at other sectors like, let's say banking, you can perhaps look at Yes Bank or IDFC or IDBI, so which would give you better returns. Yeah.
Right, Shweta, there, the expert telling that it's better to do away with ARCOM shares and in fact invest if possible in Bharti Telecom or other investing sectors like banking or so? Well, it's now time of the day where the expert gives us his pick of this day. So, what is your pick of the day?
It's TCS, and that's because the stock has corrected quite a bit. And I would expect TCS to give you at least a 50-point up move from here on. And technically, it's looking strong, and it has actually taken support at current levels, 1-1 kind of levels. So I would look at a 50-point a jump from here on. Yeah.
Well, thank you, Mr. Kishore, for joining us. Well, the markets at this point are trading at 70% high. It's at 18. The Sensex is at 18,491, whereas the Nifty is still hovering around 5,554, up by 22 points. Let's see if it closes in green today. Well, that's all we have time for on Stocks Calling. Do stay tuned to NDTV.